So we have seen the diagnosis, the risk factors and the management and the patient education related to asthma. Now let us look at some information on COPD. The definition of COPD, it's a chronic condition, it's a progressive disease. Remember, we need not write off the patient of COPD. It is treatable and preventable, mostly fixed airway obstruction with minimal or non-reversible airways by bronchodilators due to exposure to noxious agents, two entities, namely chronic bronchitis and emphysema. Chronic bronchitis, productive cough for a period of 3 months in each of the 2 consecutive years, absence of any other identifiable cause of excessive sputum production, airflow limitation that is not fully reversible, abnormal inflammatory response to noxious agents, particularly smoking. Emphysema is a pathological diagnosis. There is alveolar wall destruction, irreversible enlargement of the air spaces distal to the terminal bronchiole without evidence of fibrosis. ROAD and COPD. ROAD, recurrent obstructive airway disease or reversible obstructive airway disease, bronchial asthma, seasonal, recurrent in nature, sensitizing agent is the cause, other atopic innate causes may be there, genetic predisposition and atopy may be there, reversible bronchial obstruction demonstrated by spirometry, inflammation of the airways is the hallmark. Whereas COPD or COLD, chronic obstructive lung disease, irreversible chronic noxious agent is the cause, chronic bronchitis and emphysema are the 2 types, or there could be a combination of both. Usually smoking is the culprit. Are COPD and bronchial asthma 2 diseases or 1 disease? It's a big question. There are 2 hypotheses. The Dutch hypothesis says that they are 2 different facets of the same disease. The Swedish hypothesis says they are 2 different entities. Nonetheless, in asthma, there is reversibility of airway obstruction. In COPD, there is very little reversibility of airway obstruction. So, there is a horizon, there is an area of overlap between COPD and asthma, from full reversibility to partial reversibility to no reversibility. Asthma, emphysema, chronic bronchitis, they overlap one another. They share certain common features in some areas. They are independent and exclusive in some areas. So, airflow obstruction is the underlying denominator for both. The common thing between both is airflow obstruction. What causes airflow obstruction in asthma is airway inflammation due to allergens, inflammatory response. Whereas in chronic bronchitis, it is due to the noxious agent with a chronic inflammation, and it is partially reversible or totally irreversible. What are the risk factors for COPD? The host factors, particularly genetic, alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency, hyper responsiveness to the airways, lung growth is reduced, low birth weight, and then age are important host factors. Exposure to tobacco smoke is the most important offending agent. Biomass fuel smoke, open fires, cow dung, firewood, occupational dust and chemicals, infections, overcrowding, damp environment, low socioeconomic status, low dietary vegetable and fruit intake. These are the different factors which can influence the development of COPD. The most important risk factor being cigarette smoking. There is a concept of what is called pack years of smoking. Each patient, each smoker, we have to write the pack years. Pack years means number of packets per day multiplied the number of years of smoking. Suppose a person smokes, let's say, 1 packet per day into 10 years, his pack years will be 10. Another patient, 3 packets per day, for 15 years, these packets will be 45. Then greater the number of packets, the greater is the damage and the more is the reason for COPD to set in. Look at the changing cultures, increasing the number of women smokers, passive smokers, young babies who are exposed to passive smoke of their mothers, their friends, their fathers, their other family members. So, passive smoking. Intense cause for concern. Smoking is becoming a menace. Even in the very young age group, children taking to smoking, trying to copy their friends and peers. In colleges, no need to say, lots of peer pressure. Smoking has become a sort of hallmark of civilization, status, dignity, and what not. Look at the effect of smoking on mortality. This curve, the upper one, represents never smoked or not susceptible to smoke. So, their mortality over a period of years up to 75, if you trace around 75 to 80% of them, they survive around 75 years of age. Whereas those who have smoked regularly and susceptible to its effects, their mortality around 50 years time, by the age of 50, there is a mortality of around 40%. By the age of 60 years, their mortality will be around 70% or 75%. Had they stopped smoking at that time, around 45 years, then they gain extra 15 years of life. Stopped at 45, they get extra 15-20 years of life. They stopped at the time of disability, around say 55-60 years, still they will get some benefit. So, it is important to notice that if the effects of smoking are to some extent reversible, and patient can get benefited at any stage, the earlier the better. Mortality among women smokers is on the rise globally. What is the pathogenesis of COPD? Noxious particles like smoke or biofuel gases or industrial pollutants are inhaled. Lung inflammation sets in patients who have favorable host factors for the disease. Antioxidants which protect the lungs no more function because of the lung inflammation. There is oxidative stress. Oxidative stress increases the COPD propensity. Lung inflammation coupled with antiproteinases, genetic defects like alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency, proteinases are increasing. There is protein decision of the respiratory alveolar mucous membranes, and repair mechanisms are at fault, and then alveolar destruction can occur, and then terminal bronchioles can also be destroyed, leading on to COPD. So, the inflammation of the small airway disease, airway inflammation, airway remodeling, and small airways, when we say distal to the terminal bronchiole, parenchymal destruction, loss of alveolar attachments, decrease in the elastic recoil of the lung, emphysematous changes, airflow limitation. Look at the contrasting features in the pathogenesis of asthma and COPD. In asthma, it is a sensitizing agent like a house dust, like pollen, like the pets, like chemicals. Or there may be an innate atopy in the individual. In COPD, it is a noxious agent, usually cigarette smoke or any other biofuel gases or industrial exposure. Asthmatic airway inflammation, CD4 is the mediator, CD4 T lymphocytes, eosinophils predominate, mast cells are seen. Whereas COPD airway inflammation, CD8 is the mediator, macrophages are the main cells that play the havoc, neutrophils predominate. The effect is completely reversible in case of asthma, completely irreversible in case of COPD, airflow limitation occurs, there is an overlap, between asthma and COPD.